Moving on to item number six, conduct a public hearing and consider a request for a zoning change from R1 single family residential zone into an R2, 2-4 multifamily residential zone at 102 Bridget Lane. I'll now open this public hearing. Are there any comments on the public hearing on the rezoning of 102 Bridget Lane? Yes, Mr. Brett, would you please approach the podium, state your name and your physical address, please?
I'm Gene Brett, I live at 404 Biloxi Street. And this zoning would affect approximately 300 to 400 feet of my frontage on Biloxi Street. I'd like to read something. This is a quote from the state law. Spot zoning is a rezoning of property that benefits a specific tract of land with a use classification that is less restrictive than provided by the original zoning ordinance. And one, in addition to that, one theory of spot zoning is when the city county departs from its zoning plan and rezones specifically, especially to benefit a small tract. It violates state law requirements stating that zoning be in accordance with the zoning plan. Nixon, Texas Municipal Zoning Law 412.2ED 1994. Thus, spot zoning is illegal because it is an arbitrary departure from the zoning plan. It will lower the property values of nearby properties for the estimated gain.
Thank you, Gene. Is there anyone else in the audience that would like to comment? Yes, ma'am. Would you please come to the podium, state your name and your physical address?
My name is Janet Stevenson, and I live at 307 Biloxi Street. I have some concerns about this being changed from a single-family zoning, in that we have worked very hard on our property and are in hopes of increasing our property, and I appreciate y'all speaking earlier about improving Glenrose and improving property values and bringing just an overall pleasant feel to Glenrose. And my concern with this being changed would be that that our property values actually drop dramatically. If I were to want to sell my home, if I were in the market to purchase a home on Biloxi Street, and I toured around the neighborhood and saw a multi-family dwelling, it would certainly change my mind, and I would not even look inside the house. I would just keep on driving and look elsewhere. So I hope that you'll consider that and all the homeowners on Biloxi Street whenever you consider rezoning.
Thank you. Anyone else in the audience like to come and comment on item number six, rezoning of 102 Bridget Lane? Abbott. Then entertain at this time a motion to close the public hearing on the rezoning of 102 Bridget Lane. Have a motion from Councilman Ramsey and a second from Councilman Martin to close the public hearing on the rezoning of 102 Bridget Lane. All those in favor? Any opposed? Let the record show that's 4-0 in favor of closing the public hearing on the rezoning of 102 Bridget Lane from R1 single family residential zone to an R2. 2-4 multifamily residential zone. Okay, moving on at this time, I would open discussion from the council on this rezoning change. Councilman Ramsey?
Yes, I have a question for our attorney. In your statement, you said that across the street is R2 and R3 lots. Which street were you talking?
I believe the opposite side of Moran Street there, correct? Okay. All the area you see there that's shaded the orange, brownish color is going to be primarily R3, I believe, actually.
But that's across Highway 1.
It is.
So it's not a street, it's the actual highway.
Correct.
That's where my confusion came in, because to me, across the street would be the late Charles Sanderson's place, Triangle, and it is R1.
In regards to the issue of spot zoning, primarily, I don't feel like this is going to be a spot zoning issue. It's also withdrawn against the city claiming that. I feel very good about our chances of being successful because this is a request to go to the R2, which only allows up to a quadplex. If we were considering a rezoning request to industry or a downtown district or business of some type, then I think we might have an issue. Or even to a multifamily consisting of, you know, 50 apartment complex unit, then there might be an issue here. But the fact that we're only discussing from a single family to a single structure, but multifamily only limited to a quadplex, I think that really, in my opinion, is going to negate any claims to spot zoning. One other thing, Mayor, if I can, just for the council's consideration of this issue. Under ordinances, if you deny this application for zoning, you do ban the applicant for 180 days from reapplying for rezoning chapter. So.
No, go.
Councilman Martin.
Yeah, since this thing is completely surrounded by R1, to me, it is spot zoning. And the fact that you're putting multifamily dwelling, could be a multifamily dwelling in there, it's like the young lady said, it's gonna impact, I feel like, the value of property around it negatively. So I can't see saying that this is not spot zoning if it's completely surrounded by R1.
Yes, Councilman Ramsey.
Well, my issue is not spot zoning. I mean, that's out the window. I just feel like, having driven up and down the alley, all around Biloxi, up all those streets around in there, the only thing I saw was single housing dwelling. And I feel like by making it where it can be a duplex or quadplex, that it will affect the value of the houses and the land around it.
Councilman Martin.
We got one of the things. There was mention made that there had been no new construction in that area, and that this might be vitalized. Well, to me, all the Plushy Street in behind this, I don't know which house this young lady lived in, but that whole, all them houses right in behind that on Plushy Street are all, I know a two-story house has been there, how long would that been there, Gene, about 3 years?
10 years.
You know, so it's fairly new construction on all, they're all brick homes down through there. It's pretty late, pretty recent construction.
And I want to say, in my experience is in 50 years, to put an R2 or R4 and one.
Gene, you need to go to the podium, please, if you're speaking.
Pardon?
You need to go to the podium, sir, if you're going to speak. Thank you.
In my experience of 50 years or so, if you put a R2, R3, or R4 next to in a R1 area, it will always deplete the property values, neighboring property values.
Yes, Marilyn.
I'm younger than Gene, so I don't have 50 years of experience, and I say that teasingly. The intent, again, and I know when you're doing the zoning, to say to duplex or fourplex, I know that just kind of goes in there together, to even if this does not pass, Kim's intent was to never see an apartment, fourplex, anything of that nature. We were trying to allow, in the event someone wanted to do a duplex, and as we talked to the PNC that night, she would be willing to restrict it when it was being sold, to de-restrict it where it could go no further than a duplex. I certainly don't want to see property values drop anywhere in Glen Rose. That's how I make my living, and to decline it. I don't think anything that caused the neighborhood to decline, and her intent was to never see anything of that nature go in there. It's just the size of a lot seemed conducive to maybe go towards a duplex. Not even anyone asking to do that. We were just looking for permission in the event all at one time.
Thank you, Marilyn. Any other comments from the council? Any question, debate? Councilman Jones.
We'll go back to the replatting. You know, that's still up we've already denied that right now, so.
But that's a separate issue.
True, but unless they, unless we're able to carve that up, they're not going to be able to put a, anything out there right now. So right now, I think we could ignore the request for the zoning.
We can't.
You can't.
We can't.
No.
We have to vote up or down on the P&amp;Z's for P&amp;Z approved it. And it would be one lot at this point. I mean, we have to vote up or down on the P&amp;Z's recommendation. That's correct, Brady?
They correct, yes, Mayor.
Thank you. So I would be looking at this moment to entertain a motion for or against the zoning of 102 Bridget Lane from R1 to R2. Councilman?
I make the motion that we deny the zoning to an R2 and leave it as is.
I have a motion from Councilman Martin to deny the zoning from R1 to R2 on 102 Bridget Lane. Yeah. What'd I say?
Martin.
I'm sorry. I have a motion from Councilman Ramsey to deny the zoning change on 102 Bridget Lane from R1 to R2.
No,
I have a second from Councilman Martin. Those in favor of denying the change?
Aye.
Those opposed? Did I see all those hands again? All those in favor? Okay. Let the record show that's 4-0 to deny the zoning request at 102 Bridget Lane.